Now the shock absorbers are finished and fitted to the vehicle, it's time to move on to the final component of the StuG III G suspension. This is our Panzer III, and these are bump stops. And there's a lot more to them than what you might initially think. There are ones for the right side, there are ones for the left side, separate ones for the front, and for the rear. There are also these pieces that are attached to the swing arms that slot into a guide to prevent twisting and lateral movement. Beau was absolutely dreading this step, but luckily, since our StuG is such a late model, the Germans in its manufacture implemented some cost and time saving measures that are going to help us out immensely. Hi, I'm Kurt from Oz Armour, and welcome to Workshop Wednesday.
In the last episode, we saw Beau working on these shock absorbers. The outer sleeves were too badly damaged for us to use, so we got these sleeves made by a muffler shop in town, finishing them off beautifully. It's time to fill up the remaining bolt holes in the hull with the final component of the suspension system, the bump stops.
So what do you got there?
So this is a front or a rear bump stop, and this one is from the right side of the vehicle. On the left-hand side, this hole is actually offset on both the front and rear bump stop, whereas on the right-hand side here, you've got the hole in the center. I think it's got something to do with the torsion bar housing inside. If this hole was in this spot on the other side, I think it would foul on internal components. See where it's been on the hull before, and it's sort of protected the plate. The plate around it's pitted, but this here is quite nice and flat still. Without it, the torsion bar could break and it could damage the running gear.
Is this from this tank?
All four of our bump stops are from this vehicle.
And they're okay to use?
Yeah, they're all perfect. All original rubber, everything's original. This one's even got original bolts on it. You can see that they're a tapered bolt. They seal the hull, stop water getting through-ish, and they also stop the bolt being penetrated through the hull if they get hit.
Beau grabbed a spare swing arm to show us exactly how they work.
So this piece here has a cutaway in the back that's been milled out to fit over this stub axle and circlip, and they've been machined individually to suit each specific swing arm, so they're not all in the same spot. So there's two types of guides. The bump stop we just put on, the single bump stop with no guide built in, the guide system is this here.
Okay, and that bolts to the hull.
And that bolts onto the hull. That runs inside this block here.
Okay, so instead, if this was one of the four middle swing arms, then it would use this type of bump stop.
That's right.
Okay.
So as the swing arm moves up and down, this piece rotates inside.
And it should have rubber under there.
It should have rubber under here, which would bottom out on top of this, on top of the swing arm. Only if it really went over something rough at a high speed. If there were to be any twisting in the swing arm at all, this system here would stop that. I did notice that the back of two of our swing arms, there are actually no bolt holes in it at all. So there's no way for this piece to actually attach to the back. These holes just weren't existent.
But it still had these on it.
It still has these parts here. I think we've just stumbled across why. This is actually one that came from this vehicle. This one is from a different vehicle. This measures 25 mil. This one measures about 15. The guide fits nicely on this one. It's got a little bit of play, like it should. And then you try and put that guide on here. There is no way that is going to work. So that led me to believe that they had deleted this part altogether on the back of the middle four swing arms, and they had. They had. Somewhere along the way, we believe maybe late 1944, they actually deleted them from the middle four swing arms altogether, and just made the vehicle a lot simpler, a lot easier to produce. And they stopped machining these, and they got rid of the other block that runs over them. But it still serves as a bump stop.
They must have had just stacks of them in stock, and yeah, they were just using them up.
They would have been pre-cast by the thousands, and they would have just had heaps of them. That saved me a lot of work, because as you know, the hull on this isn't exactly dead straight. And for something, a design like this to work, you need your surfaces to be dead straight. So that was an absolute nightmare to be thinking about just even starting on setting up these guides. So to have figured this out and only having to do the front and rear guides is really good news for us. We have two left, two right of everything, and we have four of the left-hand bump stops in the middle and four of the middle right-hand bump stops also. It's just that some of those aren't exactly in usable condition right now. This one, as you can see, is like a banana.
Oh.
And I don't like bananas.
Pressing this, it wouldn't work, would it?
Pressing this will work, but not if you're going to be using it the way it was intended to.
Right.
So just to press it back into shape and be used as a bump stop is going to be completely fine. This one actually came from this vehicle. So in the earlier videos, you can see they're still attached to the part of the hull with the brake assembly and the sprocket still attached to the outside plate. And this one, seems to be fine apart from the cracking. And it's missing the bottom half triangular piece on the bottom, which now, like the other one, it's not going to matter anyway because it's just used as a bump stop. And then we've got a fourth one here, which is still attached to a piece of plate that came from a StuG. And we know this is StuG and not Panzer 3 because of this on the back. And that is part of the gun mount where it bolts onto the inside of the hull.
Like what we were just making a few weeks ago.
Like what we just made, yeah.
Give it a knock with the hammer.
Hit the handle.
Yeah.
That ruins the ratcheting inside. Oh. Had come straight off if I had a rattle gun. In reverse.
One thing that always strikes me during this sort of work is that the last time this was a part would have been 80 years ago.
See the packers underneath?
It's one big one. Oh, two big ones.
Two large ones. The whole idea of that packer there would be to space the that entire housing away so that it lined up perfectly with that guide. Now I'm just going to try and figure out how where I want to press it. It's a bit awkward, this bit, because it's got a twist in it. It's not anything to really worry about. I'm just going to try and figure out where to press.
get any better than that.
Then?
To have to fabricate or perfectly restore 12 of these bump stop units would have added weeks to the project. And with Oz Armour Fest getting closer by the day, this is time we just don't have. We won't be driving at high speed over rough terrain or through trenches, so it's unlikely these swing arms will ever make contact with these pieces. But it is a real bonus that this late war cost saver is authentic and historically accurate. Beau had a little bit more work to do to get these ones right, but we were keen to see how everything would look complete, so we decided to put the left side together.
Oh man. Yep. That's it.
Oh, drop the hammer.
No. On this side here, we had a different story. We didn't have to mill the back of this. We actually had to pack it the opposite way. We've got packers here, and you can see I've got one mil packer up top, and that's to lay the block over slightly because same as the front, it's not sitting dead level. This will just bring it slightly on a bit of an angle and allow it to go through the guide straight. Four bolt holes in each of the cast bump stops with the slide integrated into them. So we've just realized that only three of it out of the four bolt holes we can actually use for now because one of the bolt holes taps into the torsion bar housing. To align the torsion bar housing with this bolt hole is next to impossible on a vehicle that's been blown up. We can put these two bolts in and the one at the top, but then when we go to put this one in, the bolt actually comes from the outside and through this hole here, which is tapped into the torsion bar housing.
Usually we make discoveries like this earlier in the process. This is a little bit annoying to miss this detail, but three bolts will be more than strong enough to hold them in place.
So something we forgot to mention earlier is that On here we've got a 16 mil bolt, and at the top we've got a 20 mil bolt. We don't know why, it's just the way that they've made it. Why not?
It was only a short episode this week and it was pretty technical, but nonetheless, we thank you for joining us and hope you enjoyed it. The suspension has been the most tedious and difficult part of the build, but now it's complete. We'll be moving on to the really exciting parts of the restoration now, like drive lines, the brake and steering systems, internal fit out, and much more. But that's all we have time for today. Join us next Wednesday for your weekly tank restoration fix. So until then, I'm Kurt from Oz Armour, and I'll see you on the next one.